everyone, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, welcome. We're the Garceau twins. We would love if you would subscribe before you leave. Today we're going to be talking all about our favorite brushes, and a few weeks ago we had a comment in a video asking if we had a video like this, and we thought it was a fantastic idea because we definitely have favorite brushes, and so we're filming it now. Really get to see our differences here because Britta has majority or a lot of eye brushes. Mm-hmm. I don't wear a lot of eyeshadow, so I don't have that many eye brushes. I have more face brushes, so this is kind of where we have a difference of opinion. Yeah, and like for instance, Carly likes to apply her foundation with a brush, mm-hmm. and I prefer a beauty sponge or beauty blender, so I don't even have a foundation brush to share. Yeah, so we're gonna go in the order that you apply makeup, so for the first part, I'll probably have more to talk about. So starting with foundation, I have one all-time favorite foundation brush. It is the IT Cosmetics Love is the Foundation Brush. It's this like cute pink sparkly heart-shaped semi-dense synthetic brush. And if you haven't tried IT Cosmetics brushes, they're probably my favorite brushes besides Real Techniques. We'll talk about
those. They're really good. They're just expensive.
They're really good, and they're definitely the ones I spent my money on. And I think that they're all worth it. Like, all the brushes I've had from them have lasted a really long time, and they just apply everything flawlessly. The best part about this brush, besides the shape, because the heart actually makes it really easy to, like, get into your nose and everything, is just the perfect density. Like, I don't know if you can tell, but it's not too dense, and it's not too flimsy, where it's, like,
Spreading it out
and getting all streaky. I got this after Kathleen Lights recommended it, and I usually like everything she likes, and I was not surprised that I love this. It is limited edition, and they bring it back every year during Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so it should be coming back next year. I'm sorry it's not available now.
In October,
yes. But a similar brush, which is also one of my other favorite brushes for complexion, is the IT Cosmetics. This is called the Heavenly Luxe Complexion Perfection. It's the number 7 brush. And so this side is like for foundation or cream products, and then this side is for concealer or other cream products. So I actually love this brush because it's one of the only dual-ended brushes that I've found that really, really works, and I love both sides. I think it has a similar density and obviously feel because they're the same brand as this one. This one's a little less dense. So I actually really love this for cream bronzer, cream contour. Like, I just kind of blend it out. It blends out super easy. I have used it for foundation. It's really beautiful. It isn't, because it's not as dense as this, it applies like a sheer coverage, but it still really works great for foundation. And I've had this one longer than this, and it just looks pristine. Like, I'm just shocked at how amazing it's lasted. And then this side is actually really good for concealer. So I love traveling because I can just do the foundation with this side and and concealer with this side. And I don't cream contour my nose, but I feel like if you did, this would be like perfect for that because both sides are synthetic. So definitely an amazing complexion brush, and both sides are totally usable. And if you can tell, it's kind of a tiny brush, so it's really, really great for travel. Next up are powder brushes. I don't have a face powder brush that I really like because, I don't know, I don't like applying a lot of powder to the outer perimeters of my face. And I feel like most brushes apply too much, in my opinion. But I do have one that I love for setting the under eye, and it is the e.l.f. Small Tapered Brush. And I just washed it, so it's a little bit funky looking, but it is what it says. It's a small tapered brush, and I feel like since it is quite fluffy, it doesn't dispense too much powder, so it's like perfect for just sweeping under your under eyes and setting that concealer down. I also use it to set my eye primer or concealer for eyeshadow, and then I use it to set my nose and like around my mouth for my smile lines, and then I'll use just like a bigger face powder brush for the rest of my face. But I feel like this is really good for powdering smaller areas of the face that you really want to set. And I think it's $4, so it's such a steal. e.l.f. has so many brushes, and we have a few in this video, and I think it's good to narrow it on the ones that work because a lot of them aren't as well made as others, but this one is really good. And in the reviews, a lot of people say that they also use it for highlighter, so it seems like it's a dual purpose type of brush. Okay, for my powder brushes, I have two. This one is my all-time favorite. It is the Luxie Precision Foundation Brush. I don't think there's a number, that's just what it's called. and it's also synthetic, and I love this for under the eyes. Like, as you can see, it just fits perfectly. So I usually set my under eyes, like here in my nose and my chin, with this. Sometimes when I'm lazy, I'll just finish my face with this. But for an all over, just like quick dusting of powder, I like the Morphe E3 brush. It is tapered also, but it kind of like flattens out when you press it to your skin. So I like that. As you can tell, I really like flat brushes.
Yeah, why don't I have this?
Yeah, it's good. I really like flat brushes for powdering, so it doesn't mess up what you've already put down. So
this is good.
Yeah, it's good. It's a nice brush. So these are my powder brushes. Love them both. Next up is bronzer. So the one Carly's going to talk about I love as well, but this is a new find for me. It's the Real Techniques bronzer brush, and it came in a set, but I mean, I hope they release the bronzer brush on its own because I don't think the set's available anymore. But as you can see, it's huge. It's quite large. Yeah, and it's a duo fiber brush, and so I feel like most people would think that it would pack on too much color, but I washed it yesterday and I used it today for bronzer, and you can barely tell there's any bronzer on there. It does, like, I feel like the bristles are tapered, so as it gets to the end of the brush, there are less bristles, if that makes sense, so it doesn't pick up too much product, but since it is duo fiber, it blends it out flawlessly, and I don't really contour that much, so I kind of put my bronzer like in the hollows of my cheeks and then on the perimeter of my face. So for me, this is a good size because it's so quick to do my bronzer, and I just love how it looks. It just makes my bronzer look glowy and diffused and beautiful, and it's, I mean, Real Techniques is like, I don't know, they're just amazing. We love so their brushes, and they're so affordable, and the handle is adorable, and they're just really well made. So I love this bronzer brush. I really hope they sell it individually soon. This is kind of similar, and this is my favorite bronzer brush. It is the e.l.f. Large Stipple Brush. I truly don't know if this is for sale anymore. We will link it down below.
It went on clearance for a while.
Yeah, if it is. And I'm sorry but if any of these aren't available, but we just wanted to share what truly are our favorite brushes, even if they're not available, if that makes sense. But this was recommended by Alana Davidson. We love her here on YouTube, and she uses it in like every tutorial, so we both picked it up after seeing her use it, and it applies bronzer just flawlessly. It's another duo fiber brush. It's not as large as the Real Techniques one, and because it's a duo fiber and because it's not very dense, it just applies bronzer so gracefully, and you're not like, wow, that's a lot of bronzer, now I have to blend it out. So that's what I love about it. And it's really easy to turn on its side if you want more of like a contoured look. I hope that they still make this and they'll continue to make it because it's like $4 and it's just amazing.
Yeah, as a rule of thumb, I feel like we've always loved duo fiber brushes for bronzer.
Yes.
Because it diffuses it instead of looking like a harsh contour type of situation. So if you like more natural looking makeup like we do, definitely go the duo fiber route.
Next up is blush. We have the same one. This is the Morphe E4. We've been using this for years. It is the best blush brush in existence.
Yeah, I've honestly tried to find one I liked more. I have purchased a lot of blush
brushes.
You have
tried a lot. I was like, this is one and done for me.
Because, so this is pretty dense, and normally, again, with the bronzer, like, I don't want to apply a ton of blush and then have to blend it out. But I find that if I'm just really light-handed with this,
yeah,
the shape is just the best thing ever.
It just goes right here.
It can't
here.
Be beat.
It is just
perfection.
Like, you know?
Yeah, it's the shape.
Because we like to put
softness.
Our blush up the cheek to make your face look lifted and more defined.
Chiseled.
A little bit more chiseled. And this just allows you to do that, like, literally effortlessly.
Yeah.
But if you like a more blended look, just be a little careful because it is dense and it's synthetic, so it will apply a lot if you're not careful.
Yes.
Okay, next up is highlighter, and we have different ones. Mine is the Real Techniques setting brush, and I recently went back to this. I was using the Anastasia highlighter brush, I think it's the A23, for a long time, and I liked it, but then I went back to this, and I like this a lot more, and it's more affordable. I really like that it's not very dense, and it's just such a nice, it's so like so soft. Again,
yeah,
it's synthetic. I think that you can apply it on its side, or you can kind of like do swirly motions and apply the highlighter this way, and it just is so perfect for every little spot. I think it's more precise, and I really like that in a highlighter brush because I don't want to get it like everywhere. So this is like an amazing brush, and I do think it would be really great for setting under the eyes.
Yeah, I think I have two or three of them.
Oh,
like
really?
One for contour, one for highlighter, and then one for setting the under eyes. It's a bit too dense for me for setting under eyes, but it works.
Yeah, it's such a good brush.
And then I have the Morphe R36. This, as you can see, is a bit fluffier than the Real Techniques, so it gives a more diffused highlight. I feel like on a day-to-day basis, I'll use this, and you can kind of like put it, not everywhere, but you don't have to be as precise because it does apply less product. So I'll use like the Essence Pure Nude, something more natural, and just put it kind of like all over. And then if I want to add more intensity, I'll use the Real Techniques setting brush, and I'll just put it at the tips of my cheekbones because that one packs on more highlighter. Mm-hmm. So if I'm feeling like a smoky eye, all glammed out look, I'll use a more natural highlight, and then I'll use something more metallic just on the tops of my cheekbones with that one. So it just depends on what kind of highlighter you're going for, mm-hmm. but this is really good for day to day because it adds such a like nice diffused highlight look. Just a rule of thumb too, like this is a natural hair brush,
yeah,
so it will always apply less product than synthetic.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
If you like a more natural look, natural hair brushes are probably the way to go. And last up is a super random favorite, but this is the Luxie Mini Angled Brush. And I don't contour my nose every day by any means, but whenever I do, this is the perfect one to do so with because it is so small and angled that you can literally just like put it on either sides of your nose, cream or powder it works with, and blend it out because it is, it is almost like a duo fiber, I wanna say. So it does blend it out really nice as well, so it doesn't deposit too much product. So if you're into nose contouring, this is a really good option. My all-time favorite crease brush is definitely the Sephora Pro Crease Brush. It's number 10. I got this on sale. It was on sale like a year ago. I love it so much. Again, another Kathleen Lights recommendation. She uses it all the time. It's really fluffy, as you can tell, and quite large. And it's a natural hair bristle. So it really, really barely puts any color down. And it's so easy to diffuse it in your crease, which I love because I have kind of, I wouldn't say hooded eyes. I don't even know how to describe them.
They're just a bit droopy.
A bit droopy. There's a lot of folds on them. So I always have to start my eyeshadow like pretty high up in my crease. So this, because it's large, is really easy to just put a lot of color in a large space. So I really, really, really love this. If you have any type of eye shape though, I think you would like this brush. And my favorite crease brush is the Morphe R36. I could barely read this. I use it so much. It actually looks really similar.
A little, yeah.
Yeah, I feel like they're super similar. But this is the Morphe R36, and I use this every day because most days I don't feel like doing a full eyeshadow look, but I'll at least throw something in my crease just to, you know, give it some dimension and make it me look more awake. And this one is just perfect for throwing a shade in the crease. You can blend it onto the eyelid a little bit, but it still puts the pigment where you first put it on your eye, if that makes sense. And like Carly said, it just blends it out flawlessly. It doesn't put too much pigment on the eyelid, so it is a more natural look that you can build up. And yeah, I mean, it's affordable because it is from Morphe. I don't remember the exact price, but again, link it down below. This whole rose gold collection is really good from Morphe. Another rose gold one for Morphe is the R39. This is less fluffy than the one Britta's talking about and smaller. And I really love this because it's natural hair and I can use it in two ways, which I do all the time because I don't wear a lot of eyeshadow recently. I'll just throw on like one color. So I'll pack the color on my lid with the flat side like this, and then I'll buff some into my crease with like the tapered edge. And it just is so fast, so easy, and it works both ways. Like I feel like you can really put a lid color on and do a crease color. So I think the shape and just the overall, like just the overall how the brush is really works for both of those purposes. So it's, and it's affordable because it's fluffy. My favorite crease brush, well, for like a more defined crease, is the Makeup Geek Defined Crease Brush. This is a newer find, but it is an incredible crease brush because it is so small, but it is fluffy at the same time, and it's tapered. So it really allows you to pick up the pigment and then like press it into the socket and then really blend it out. And so I feel like I have other crease brushes that I do like, but they're bigger. So, you know, like for us, we do have, like we said, slightly hooded eyes. So you really want to make sure that if you're going in with like a darker crease color, that it stays where you put it. Because if it blends out too much, it'll just make your eyelids look heavy. Mm-hmm. Tati talks about this a lot, that she also likes to have like a more defined crease and put the color in one spot. So this brush is perfect if you just want to put a shade like right here and have it stay there, because it is so small, it'll blend out, but it'll still be where you initially wanted it to go, if that makes sense. So this is really, really great. I mean, this is like one of the only Makeup Geek brushes we've tried, but it's really good quality, and it is synthetic, so it's good for darker shades, I would say, just packing on color. It's not as natural looking as the first crease brush I talked about. That one's more for like an all over crease transition shade. Okay, the last crease brush we both have is the Deluxe Crease Brush by Real Techniques. This came in a set
last year.
Yeah, I don't know if they sell it separately, but I think we use this in similar ways, but also different.
Yeah.
I use a lot of cream eyeshadows. I really love the Nude Sticks Magnetic Matte pencils or eye pencils, and I use this with those like exclusively because it is synthetic, and with creams you need a synthetic brush, and it's very dense. So it's super easy to blend out the edges when I'm using cream products, or even to apply on the lid. It just gets the job done. And I also use this to blend out shades that really need blending because it's really dense. So if it's even a powder, I'll just like blend with this. It's really, really nice.
Agreed. I don't use as many cream products, but when I do, I always use this brush. And like Carly said, I will use it to blend the transition shade. Mm-hmm. And usually if it's a darker one, if it's lighter, I'll just use my normal crease brush because it won't really matter. But if it's darker and you want it to be more diffused, I'll use this after the eye look is done, and I'll just blend everything together and blend it up so it just looks diffused and pretty and effortless. Mm-hmm.
Okay, next is shader brushes, or just lid brushes in general. I only have one. It is the BH Cosmetics number 7. It's a part of their Rose Gold collection. We'll link the collection down below because I don't believe this is sold separately, but the whole thing is super affordable.
Yeah.
It's a synthetic brush, and as you can see, it's very, very flat, and it's super densely packed. So I love this. When I get wild and use glitters or really intense shimmers, it doesn't happen often, but when I do, this is the only brush I'll pack it on with. Sometimes I don't even need Fix Plus or a setting spray because it's so dense, it'll literally pick up like glitter pigment and put it on your eye. It's amazing. It's a really good brush, and especially for how affordable that whole set is, like, I was shocked at the quality of this brush. Okay, I have two shader brushes. The first one is the Sigma Firm Shader E57, and this is a bit shorter and fatter, so I find it's really good for matte shadows that I'm putting on the lid because it is a bit tapered. It's not as flat as your typical shader brush like the one Carly spoke about. It's super densely packed and flat. This one is a bit tapered, so it picks up just the right amount of pigment. Usually if I'm doing like an all matte eye look with some browns and then I want a cream on the lid, I'll always use this because it'll pick up just the right amount of pigment, so it doesn't look like stark cream and then going into brown. It'll almost like blend all the shades together and make it just look really beautiful. So I really like this for matte shadows, and then if I'm going in with a shimmer or a glitter, I always use the Morphe M124. It's very, very small. It's definitely a detail brush. Very flat, very densely packed and stiff. So it picks up just the right amount of pigment because there are sometimes, yeah, like Harley said, if I'm getting crazy, where I'll put a shimmer shade on the lid and then I want like a lighter shade just on the inner corner, and this is so easy to like pack right here without having to do the whole lid. So this is definitely like a precision shader brush. If you're using more than one lid shade, this is really good. Okay, last is pencil brushes, or smudged lower lash line brushes. Yeah. I have one. This looks distressed. I've had it forever. It is the Morphe M431. I think it's like $3. It's the only pencil brush I use. Again, it's natural hair, so it really diffuses and doesn't apply too much product. I like natural makeup, so when I want something under my lower lash line but nothing too intense, this is what I reach for, and I reach for it all the time. It is such a good brush. I should honestly probably replace it because it does look a little disheveled, but I did just wash it, so maybe that's why. It's so good for how affordable it is. And I have two that are similar. I have the Morphe R41, again from the Rose Gold collection. This is a goat hair brush, and this I actually use as a pencil brush, but as you can see, it's a bit larger than your typical pencil. So I use this for the outer V because we do have slightly hooded eyes, and when I do an outer V, I need to like be super precise in where I put that pigment so that it doesn't go into the crease too much and make my eyes look more droopy than they are. So this one is perfect because it is so dense that you can literally just press it in the outer V and then blend it slightly, and it is perfect. It's perfection. So I love that for the outer V. And then I have the Real Techniques Smudge Brush. It came in the set with the bronzer brush. As you can see, this is very short and dense, and this is perfect for just smudging color under the lower lash line. I used to use a flat top definer brush, and I would like press pigment under there and then use a pencil brush to blend out that pigment, and this one kind of does a two-in-one situation. I can just like kind of press it and then blend it, and it's super quick. It looks super diffused and beautiful. I love this. It's one of my favorite Real Techniques brushes for sure. As an honorable mention, we wanted to talk about our favorite brush cleaner. This is the Sephora Solid Brush Cleaner. It's a dupe for the Beauty Blender one, but we think this one works better.
Yeah.
And it's like only $2 cheaper, but it still is. As you can see,
Mine's completely gone. I have to get a new one.
It's so good. I also have a travel size one for traveling. It comes with this silicone, what is it called? Like a scrubby thing?
Yeah, like a mat.
So that you can, you basically wet your brush, swirl it in here, swirl it on the mat, and then rinse all the makeup out.
What I like to do is put the little scrubby thing in here. So then you swirl it in here, and then this has some place to hold on to, grip onto, so you can do it fairly quickly.
It just works so well. It gets out all the makeup of your brushes. It smells nice. It smells like a light scent. And it makes your brushes really soft, and it doesn't disturb the glue. I know a lot of people, when they use like heavy oil cleansers, they say that the oil will break apart the glue in the ferrule of the brush, and then their head will come out. And that's never happened with this.
No,
so this is a really, really amazing brush cleaner, and it really is affordable because I think it's like $16 for the big one.
It lasts a long time.
And it lasts forever. Thank you guys so much for watching our favorite brushes video. This was super fun to film. Let us know your favorite brushes down below.